八十八岁的老阿婆
88岁的老阿婆
不是九
今天要打客家面
我突然不知道你要我这样，我不要做的嘞。我怕你哦，没有办法。My
grandmother's name is Lim Tai Moy. You can also call her Mrs. Lam. She was born in 1929, so she's actually 88.
89啊，不要讲八十八啊，因为你是华人的啦。管他，你就讲华人哦。Five
children, 13 grandchildren, 5 great grandchildren, and 1 more on the way. In my younger days, we didn't live in the same country. I only saw her a few times a year. She was born in Malaysia. Whenever we went to visit her in Batu Pahat, there was always food in the house. Hakka yong tofu or niang tofu, udapan, which is suan panzi. She made the best Hakka food. But apart from that relationship of her feeding me, I don't think it really went deeper than that, partly because we don't speak the same language, so we didn't really have a close relationship. But then 3 years ago, my father passed away. There was this great sense of loss in the entire family. It was almost like we didn't need words to understand each other. I think this is actually what brought me and my grandma closer together. I think because I had just experienced a loss.
Hi!
I had a sense of mortality or impermanence. I wanted to spend more time with her.
Say hi!
Nine.
I would go over to her house and I would watch her cook. But she would never teach me how to cook. She always said it was too much work.
哎呦,我这个孙女生好像不太煮饭了。So
I just film her.
Nai, 再说一次。
再说一次吗?再说一次是什么?
A lot of the emphasis is in the dough making. So the first step is when you mix together the flour and the water. Pick up the little bits, clump it together, and knead it into a fist-sized dough ball. You get the ball of dough and you knead it into a flat disc. This is the part where you roll the discs into flat sheets. So she actually uses pasta making machine.
This becomes noodles.
Yes.
Serve the mincemeat with the noodles. And then you drizzle more fish sauce over. And there you have your Hakka noodles. It's happiness.
<笑>我四五岁就煮饭了，白薯板啊，木头板啊，都没有你来煮啊，自己耕种来吃的，种八宝也会，养猪我也会，养鸡我也会，养自己胖胖大大，那个穷起来啊，以前啊，你们没有收到，很辛苦。
Now when I think of the future generation, I'm always wondering whether we'd be the same family without all those conversations around the dinner table, without the stories that Nai Nai tells us, and without her food. She's still in very good health, really strong. The only thing that bothers her is her knee, so she can't stand for too long, which means she doesn't really cook that much anymore. So I'm glad that I've learned at least one dish from her. Even though she says that women of today shouldn't be spending their time in the kitchen. But I think there's really something to be said about a woman who willingly spends so much time in the kitchen just to make something that will please the entire family. That to me is love.